give all honor and glory to you, God. Father, we come this morning saying, dear God, have thine own way, Lord, have thine own way. You are the potter, we are the clay, God. Just shape us and mold us like you want us to be, God. Father, we thank you for the prayer service this morning, God. We thank you for all that you're doing in this place, dear God. And not just here, God, but in other places of worship, God. Now this morning, God, we ask in the name of Jesus that you would breathe afresh on your word, dear God. Father, give me a word that lifts you up high, dear God. Do it as only you can, God. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Good morning. I just want to say, I guess thank you to my pastor, who's not here, but who has appointed me by not appointing me. This morning, I guess we're going to come from a passage of scripture that that God has just been speaking with me on.
Okay.
And it comes from Jeremiah 29. And the 11th verse, but I want to read verses 1 through 13.
Okay.
I just thank you, my brothers and sisters, for continuing to pray for us. And it says, now these are the words of the letter that Jeremiah the prophet sent from Jerusalem unto the residue of the elders which were carried away captives, and to the priests and to the prophets and to all the people whom Nebuchadnezzar had carried away captive from Jerusalem to Babylon. After Jeconiah the king and the queen and the eunuchs and the princes of Judah and Jerusalem and the carpenters and the smiths were departed from Jerusalem by the hand of Elasa, the son of Shaphan, and Jeremiah the son of Hilkiah, whom Zedekiah king of Judah sent unto Babylon to Nebuchadnezzar king of Babylon, saying, thus says the Lord of hosts, that God of Israel, unto all that are carried away captives, whom I have caused to be carried away from Jerusalem to Babylon, build ye houses and dwell in them, and plant gardens and eat the fruit of them. Take ye wives and begat sons and daughters, and take wives for your sons, and give your daughters to husbands, that they may bear sons and daughters, that ye may be increased there, and not diminished. And seek the peace of the city whither I have caused you to be carried away captive, and pray unto the Lord for it, for in the peace thereof shall ye have peace. For thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, let not your prophets and your diviners that be in the midst of you deceive you, neither hearken to your dreams which ye cause to be dreamed. For they prophesy falsely unto you in my name. I have not sent them, said the Lord. And thus says the Lord, that after 70 years be accomplished at Babylon, I will visit you and perform my good word toward you in causing you to return to this place. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, said the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. Then shall ye call upon me, and ye shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. And ye shall seek me and find me, when you shall search for me with all your heart.
With all your heart.
This letter to the Babylonians, this was sent to Israel. And Jeremiah wrote this letter to those captives that had been carried away. Israel was God's chosen people. But Israel had become so wicked,
so wicked,
and so disobedient, uh-huh, that God allowed somebody more wicked than themselves, yeah, to hold them into captivity.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so Jeremiah here is writing to those captives because he wants to encourage them, but he doesn't write what he wants to write. In that fourth verse, it says, thus says the Lord of hosts.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Jeremiah wrote exactly what God told him to write.
That's right. That's right.
To his chosen people. And God told Jeremiah, tell my people, don't get discouraged. He said, I want them to live there in Babylon. Mm-hmm. And he makes it so plain. He tells them, build houses.
Yeah.
Now this is a wicked land again.
Yeah.
But he's telling them, look, you are my people. I haven't forgotten about you. Even in this wicked land where you are, build you some houses. You're going to be there a while. Build you some houses.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He said, not only build houses, he said, dwell in them. Plant some gardens. That means they're going to have some food to eat.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He said, and eat the fruit of them. Uh-huh. Eat the fruit of the garden that you plant. He said, take you some wives. He said, and have sons and daughters.
Yes, sir.
He said, and you give your sons and daughter into marriage. Let them have some wives. He said, that you might increase there and not diminish. See, God wasn't interested in his people going off the scene. He said, so I want you in this place where I have you in captivity. Have sons and daughters that you might increase. He said, and seek the peace of the city.
Yeah, yeah.
I want you to be peaceful in an evil land.
That's right.
I want you to have some peace there. He said, if you seek peace, peace is going to be there. But you have to seek that peace. He said, and not only that, he said, for thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God, let not the prophets and your diviners that's in the midst of you deceive you. So what he was saying to them, there are false prophets there in the land.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He said, but don't pay enough any attention to the false prophets. He said, because they're going to tell you, you don't need to be there. You need to be rebellious. He said, but I want you to know that I have not sent them. They are not a part of me. Make sure that you pay no attention and put no stock into nothing they say. He said, for thus says the Lord, after the 70 years, you are going to be there a whole 70 years. But after the 70 years have been accomplished, he said, I will visit you and perform my good word toward you, causing you to return to Israel.
All right,
that's what God does.
Yeah.
He said, you don't have to worry. You're going to spend some time there. I want you to spend some time there. The time that you are going to spend in Babylon is going to be for your good.
That's right.
So you do all that you can. All that I have said in this letter.
Uh-huh.
Dwell therein. Uh-huh. Like it's your home.
Yeah. Yeah.
Knowing that after all this is done, with 70 years over,
uh-huh,
I'm going to bring you back home.
That's
to
right.
Your real home.
That's right.
And so I just wondered about all of this, and I was thinking about Abraham. Joseph, who God had allowed to be exiled.
Uh-huh.
And all of the things that Joseph went through. And he went through them unjustly. But even in all of that, God used Joseph for a mighty work.
That's right.
For such a time as the children of Israel would get hungry. Joseph went through a lot. But God said, I know the plans I got for you, Joseph. Don't get caught up into being sold into captivity. Don't get caught up into being forgotten in jail. Don't get caught up, Joseph, in the things that seem like they're going against you. Because I know the plans that I have for you. Isn't that awesome when God said, I know the plans I have for you? It's just like Saul, who became Paul, persecuting the Christians.
Yeah.
that God had a plan for.
Yeah.
That's just like you and I.
Yeah.
Don't give up on our children.
Don't
they don't look right. They're not acting right.
No.
They're not doing right. But God got some plans for those children. Just like he got plans for the prostitute. Just like he got plans for the drug dealer. They're not doing any of what God has called them to be. Because remember in the scripture, God said he wished that none would be lost. That all would come unto repentance. And so he knows the plans that he has for them. Oh God, he knows the plan that he has for us. He knows the plan that he has for us. We didn't start out right where we are now. Oh, if I could just go back and remember all of the things and all of the ways I dishonored God. Not sharing any glory about that time, y'all, but I remember that I wasn't always right where I am now. But because I wasn't here, it didn't mean God didn't have plans for me. He always had plans for me. He always had plans for you. And we are not all that God is desiring us to be. Not even at this point.
No.
But God says, just hang in there. He said, I know the plans for you. He said, if you call upon me. That's what he says in that the 12th verse. He said, you shall call upon me. And you shall go and pray unto me. He said, I will hearken unto you. If you just call unto me. He said, I know all the plans I got for you. We're not to give up just yet, y'all. We're not looking like we ought to look all the time, but that's okay. God said, I got plans for you. God's First Community, any of y'all ain't looking like it ought to look right now, but God got plans for First Community, any of y'all. We hear our pastor talking about the vision. And God is bringing that vision into fruition, y'all. I tell you, there was a time when the sanctuary wasn't your school, we didn't have this many people in prayer service. Oh, but God. Oh, but God. He knows the plan that he has for us. And this is not where it's going to stop. There was a time, y'all, we didn't have a discipleship hour. We had Sunday school. Oh, but now. God is using that discipleship hour to bring more and more people together talking in small groups. Sharing what God has done. Sharing what God can do. God knows the plans that he has for us. He says it's plans to prosper us. He says not plans for evil. If we just but let God be God. Let him do the work in us that he has planned for us. If we just let God, let his spirit rule in these bodies of ours. If we just take him at his word, knowing that he has a plan for us. I just want to encourage us this morning just to let God be God. All that he has called us to do, you know what he's called you to do. I know what he's called me to do.
That's right.
And we've been trying to run from it, y'all. Oh, but God said, I got a plan for you. You can build some houses in First Community, Antioch. You can have some peace in First Community, Antioch. Because I got a work for you to do that's outside of First Community, Antioch. You come in here, I got a plan for you to come in here. Fill you up, teach you what you need to know, and send you back out. Because we got a lost community, y'all. Many of our children and our family members are on their way to hell. And God said, I got plans for them. I'm going to use you to get a word to them so that they too shall not be lost, but that they shall come on in. Time is winding up, y'all. Time is winding up. And we got to allow God to do what he desires to do in our lives. He want to do some great things, but we just got to yield to him. If he said build houses, let us build houses.
All right, God.
If he said get comfortable in a bad land, get Because he knows the plans that he has for us. And so we just want to say this morning, let God be God in our lives. Let him do what he want to do. Plans to prosper us and not hurt us. Plans to move us forward. God, we love you and we thank you, God, this morning for all that you've done and all that you will do, God. God, we come knowing that you're God and you're God all by yourself, God. God, we know you have a plan for our lives. So we just yield to you, God, saying, have thine own way, Lord, have thine own way. Do it as only you can, God. Shape us and mold us into what you want us to be, dear God. Let us carry your word, dear God, wherever you told us to carry.
Oh, yeah.
Say it from the rooftop, God, in the storehouse, in the hospital, on the work site, dear God, wherever you told us to share it, God. Let us just do what you've called us to do. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.